Do you smell that, Joe?
Yeah, the air is nasty.
No, not the smog. Freedom. True God-given freedom. And this room is a symbol of our newfound liberty and independence from parents, curfews, and all the things that make me vomit. Our former oppression is behind us, and what stands before us can only be joy. Our beatitude is here, my friend. And you get the joy of sharing it with me. Okay, I'll enjoy it by myself. But wait, I don't have to do that. There's a whole school full of liberated Oh my gosh!
What? What is it?
Is that Tommy Moore? You've got to be kidding me. You mean to tell me that entire building is full of women? Who am I that I should receive? We kept prepping for classes. Let's go over there.
We don't have time, Matt.
We don't have time. Dude, we have 4 whole years to take classes. But the ladies are weedy. I see. You're gonna be a priest, aren't you?
Me? Look, it doesn't matter. I have to get out of here quickly, so I have time to pray mid after late Wednesday evening prayer for the morning. And you might want to consider joining me for Bob Rice's talk after dinner on balancing life as a college student. You might learn something.
But why go to the talk when you can experience it? Come on, there'll be more talk.
Thanks, but I'm all set.
Okay, fine. While you're having a little time to talk, I will be living the Catholic college man's dream. Oh, but first I'd better hit the gym. You think it's still open? I'm feeling a little small today. Okay, well, I'll see you later. Brooms.
And on the day that my poor kitten Fluffers passed on to our Lord, I finished my novena and saw one beautiful shining rose in the hands of the statue of Our Lady at Mass. And I just knew that the Lord was calling me to be here at Franciscan. So what's your story?
I'm sorry, Mary, but I'm just not huge on telling people I just met really personal details about them.
Oh my gosh, I totally respect that. Well, you have to be able to tell me something. Please? Please!
I don't know why I'm here, okay? God kind of just hauled me here at the last minute, and frankly, I don't know why. Does that answer your question?
Wow. That is so beautiful. Childlike trust. Wait! Do you think the Lord brought you here so that you could get your MRS degree? Excuse me? Do you think you're meant to get your MRS degree? I was talking to a couple girls down the hall, and we all decided that we have to get married by the time we graduate. Of course, the Franciscan ratio doesn't help, and all the cute boys are discerning the priesthood. But, oh, I just know that the Lord put someone here just for me.
Relax, girl. You just got here.
Well, that's true. I'm willing to wait an entire week before I need it.
I'm gonna go get myself some more coffee, because it looks like I'm gonna need more.
Oh, Teresa, you're not wearing that out of the dorm, are you?
Listen, pretty girl. I'm not here to meet a man. I'm here to take classes, get my degree, and get out. And I don't want to hear another word about it, okay?
Wow. You're so authentic!
They weren't kidding about that Franciscan ratio, were they?
Hey, my name's Matt, and I think I just met the 8th gift of the Holy Spirit.
You know they say Latin lovers are the most passionate. And baby, your form is extraordinary. That's fine. You could only ever be the second woman in my life anyway. Our blessed mother will always be. I was told everyone at Franciscan was so friendly, but I guess I'm just meeting all the pouty ones.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Symington. And this is an introduction to the foundations of biblical moral principle studies of Jesus Christ and the saints. We're going to begin right away with some information you'll need to know. Here's the syllabus for the class.
I thought this was a core class.
It is.
Oh no, I'm doomed.
You're fine, it's just theology.
Yeah, you assume.
Is there a problem over there?
No, sir.
No, sir. But wait, how was the homework?
The syllabus might say.
9 papers, all 10 pages long, hooray!
Excuse me.
Sorry, sir.
A quiz, in each class period.
A midterm, half the grade. I'll fail, I'll get a 0.
Are you afraid? I know they keep on telling me to be a student first, but Lord, is that all colleges? 'Cause that would be the worst.
Said I'd like my classes. Said I'd have more time.
Come on, I think they lied to us. This is a crime.
Yeah!
They keep on telling me
to be a student first, but Lord, is that all colleges? 'Cause that would be the worst.
Professor, you must have a family. You know it isn't fair to spend all your time grading when they need your care.
Please, Jesus, on mercy. Today, please follow your Savior by throwing these up.
This must be your first day.
Yes, sir. I just don't know how I'm gonna do it all.
Well, you're a student first.
I mean,
that's why you're here, am I wrong? To become more intelligent, earn your degree. That doesn't mean that you can't take care of you. In fact, you need to take care of you. Mentally, physically, emotionally. As much as you need to do your homework, you need to spend time on you. Go to Mass, do a ministry, out with your friends, do something. You're a person, too. But remember the main reason that you're here.
We don't mean to enslave you with work up to your ears. We just want you to learn a lot, that's why you're here. Have to be a student first, that's your vocation now. But then just let him do the rest, you know he'll show you how.
So, I can join a household?
Yeah.
Take a nap?
As long as you plan your time well.
Okay, it's my vocation now, to be a student first. I'm putting all my trust in you, I'm putting my faith first.
I know it's my vocation now, to be a student first. All glory be to God alone, I'm putting my faith first.
I think that about does it for today. I don't mind letting you go an hour and 10 minutes early on the first day of class. Look at that syllabus and come with any questions.
Hey, would you want to go to lunch?
Sure. Oh, Teresa, you are going to love me. I reorganized your entire closet and threw out all the clothes I didn't like. Now you can share my wardrobe. You can thank me later. Who's your friend?
Weren't you supposed to be in this class?
Oh. Yeah. Oops. This is Matt.
Hey, my name's Matt.
Wow, my Sacred Heart scapular just started beating fast.
That was cute. And this is... I don't think I ever learned your...
It's nice to meet you. I have to go.
Sorry, he's not very good at social interaction.
Okay, I'll meet you there.
What the heck, guys?
He's the one!
Excuse me?
The one, Teresa!
Just what? It doesn't matter. Teresa, every granny girl knows that if they are called to the married life, there's a guy here that's destined to be with them.
Thank you. How's it going?
Because of the heat. I did not know that there were sparrows sitting on the wall, and their fresh droppings fell into my eyes, and white films formed over my eyes. Huh. I wonder why he signed that one. Let's see. Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 7. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped.
Hey, Joseph, what you up to?
Just reading for some classes. You intended to Fishers?
Yeah, I did! I mean, I had to. They're obviously the best household on the planet. Hey, we're going out to talk about celebrate. You wanna come? They always love having visitors. I love it.
I'm sorry, Matt. I gotta finish this reading.
Dude, it's Friday! You've been studying all week.
No, you go on without me. Thanks, though.
I'll pay for you.
I'm all set. Thank you.
Okay, fine. Happy studying.
Psalm 42, verse 1 through 3. No, that was nothing, really.
No, really. That was unbelievable.
Thanks.
You should really consider joining music ministry or something.
but I just don't have the time.
Oh, must be because you're so busy with so much.
No, just dirty vagabond, tutoring, Thursday night homeless, Sunday nursing home ministry, 17 credits and honors.
Wow, I just wish I had the time to do all the things that you do. But I guess if I did, I'd be so busy, I'd probably just cry my eyes out. Can I hear your song again?
Oh, I really don't want to.
Nope, you're going to sing. Let's hear it.
God help me, it's 2:30 in the morning.
Morning, everyone. As I recall, you have some presents for me.
How'd the paper go last night, Joe?
It would have gone a lot better if I'd gotten a little more time to work on it.
More time? Didn't you work on it all last night?
No, because as I recall, I spent a good 2.5 hours on the phone last night.
Oh, well, I'm sure it was still wonderful. I'm sure the Lord really blessed it.
No, he didn't. You don't get it, do you? Because of you, I will probably get a B on this paper. But I'm not looking for friends right now. I am trying to get an A, and you are only in the way.
Wow. Those are two really emotional friends you've got there.
Half of it.
I would argue otherwise. I mean, do you really think that these are the first two lovesick students I've seen here at Franciscan?
What are we gonna do?
Well, have you expressed your concerns?
Kind of.
As their friends, you need to confront them directly. I mean, nothing's going to change if you don't do anything about it.
But they're certifiably insane.
Oh, I second the motion.
Aye.
And all the more reason to do so. I mean, you have to shine the light of Christ into their lives before it's too late. I would argue it's the reason that you're here. Maybe the main reason.
Can I say something?
Sure.
In that same spirit of confronting issues directly, can we move on with class? We've yet to get through one period without one of you interrupting. That's all, Professor.
Just a bit. crying's louder than the door alarm. If you still want to remain a sixth grader, be focused and be pleasantly surprised that Joseph did you very little harm. Yes, he yelled at you in front of the entire class, but did you wonder why his mood was grim? He needs a space, it's obvious, he might become a priest, and you can't keep but swoon all over him.
Self-reflection.
What you're doing is all good.
I think you never understood.
But go out with a little and have a bit of fun.
Do you never just assume that someone's gonna be the one? Stop controlling everything and let it do the work. Cause he can't do nothing if you don't let.
I don't care what you have to say, and I never did, so just get out.
I'm sorry that I care about you.
Never asked you to.
Just stop, please. I'm tired of you telling me how to live. I'm doing just fine on my own. I don't need you. I'm just trying to help. I don't need the help from somebody so anti-franny. Come in many different packages, Mary. They don't all fit the same template. That's too bad.
And someday when she gets up this hill, I pray that she'll wake up and see Christ in you and me.
Take the past 5,000 hits I gave you.
Father, what am I doing wrong? Nobody seems to get it. I do everything you ask, and then some.
Do you love?
Huh?
Do you love? As Matt told you, everything you're doing is great. But do you ever stop to love? I need you to yield to me, Joseph, and let me work. Start noticing the people around you. Only then will your life have true meaning. Do you trust me? I think I've said enough.
With no crowd. can't live like this forever. Empty and alone. Get me out of the way. I choose to leave.
Thank you. the ad drop date. If you can withdraw if you'd like, would that mean you'll fail at all? That's okay. I was failing them anyway.
Mary, what are you doing?
I'm pursuing my vocation. If this is what you wanted me to do, right? Do you offer any sort of tuition refund for quitting school to join a religious order? Sorry, hon, we don't. Huh, you'd think they'd do that here. Teresa, I'm leaving Franciscan and there's nothing you can do about it. I did some self-reflection, like you said, and I realized that I did come on too strong. So clearly, my terrible sin was a sign that I was pursuing the wrong vocation altogether. So I'm going to take my things and go to Baltimore. So go to the Dominicans and see if they'll take me in.
Mary, that is not what I meant, okay? You just need to stop planning so far in the future. Gosh, you're not even fixing the problem, you're only redirecting it. Can we go somewhere else to talk?
I'm leaving Franciscan and there's nothing you can do about it.
Mary!
Hello, Joseph.
Mary, can we talk?
I've wanted to talk for half a semester and you're ready when I'm walking out the door? No, thank you.
Mary, I screwed up! I screwed up!
Okay, yes, we can talk. Yeah.
Mary, I'm sorry. I thought I was doing everything right. I thought to be holy, I had to earn my way to heaven, but it turns out I was so caught up in my books that I didn't take time to look up and see the people around me.
I'm pretty sure I made myself obvious, Joseph. I know you saw me.
Well, yeah. I don't even know you. I don't even know your last name. Does she have a last name? Look, I'd like to know your name before we size you for a ring. Perhaps your favorite color or the songs you like to sing. It couldn't hurt to sit around and play a game or two. I'd like to take you on a date and learn more about you. Let's make it clear, one date is all for now. A date to get to know you. Then we'll see what God allows. And I know here at Steubenville, most tend to rush these kinds of things. So, what do you say?
I would like that.
Wait, do you still want to drop all your classes?
I think I'm all set, thanks.